from KMBC 9 News, this is First News with Maria Antonia and meteorologist Bryan Busby.
Good morning. Welcome to First News. I'm Maria Antonia. It's 6:30 in the morning.
And I'm Bryan Busby. It's 17 degrees, and this is our First News.
Very first day. Bryan and I will be here every morning with the First News. We'll have national and local headlines, let you know what's going on around the country and here in the Kansas City area. Also, if you are trying to decide which coat to grab, we'll have the temperatures and also talk about the trouble spots on the road so that you can avoid delays on your way to work. And here is what's happening in the news this morning. The best news for some of you is today is a federal holiday. It's President's Day and many government offices are closed. So before you hop in the shower, think, are you supposed to work today? And if you were thinking of picking up some cash today, many banks are closed. So again, think again. The rest of you who have to work this morning, you might want to get an early start. It sounds like a broken record, but our streets are kind of slippery this morning. It started last evening. Wet snow fell and froze, and driving got tricky before nightfall. Overnight streets developed a glaze, so you may want to use some extra caution. A five-hour police standoff ended early this morning on the city's east side. A man with a gun was barricaded an apartment complex in the 4500 block of Colonial Drive. Police were finally able to talk him out just a couple of hours ago. No one was injured. And investigators in Overland Park have a busy day ahead. They've got another arson fire on their hands. It looks like someone set fire to another apartment under construction, this one at 124th and Craig. Fire officials have been looking for the people who've been setting these fires for some time. One firefighter was heard fighting the blaze yesterday. In West Virginia, investigators believe a compressor used to make snow touched off an explosion and fire that killed three employees at a ski resort. Firefighters say the men were apparently trying to repair the machine at the Cannon Valley Resort when the accident occurred. The White House this morning is denying that there are Russian missiles in Cuba pointed at the U.S. Republican presidential candidate Pat Robertson made that claim last night during a GOP debate in New Hampshire. Robertson said he had information there are 25 Soviet missiles in Cuba. Robertson aides today are backtracking on that comment, saying the candidate meant missile launching systems, not the missiles themselves. Former presidential candidate Senator Joe Biden is in satisfactory condition this morning after emergency surgery Friday for an aneurysm in an artery. The 45-year-old Delaware senator should recover fully. The senator had been complaining of neck pain the past weeks. In San Diego, police are investigating the Great Doughboy Caper. It happened at a hotel where the National Bake Off competition is taking place. The lobby was filled with company trademarks, and during the weekend, a man grabbed the Green Giant and the Pillsbury Doughboy and started to run. He dropped the giant but tossed the 4-foot-tall Doughboy into his car and sped away. Pillsbury says it is offering a reward for their Doughboy. And now the moment we've all been waiting for, the weather on this Monday morning. Now, Bryan, what is going on? The Doughboy is missing.
I was just curious about what's the ransom on that? What, a recipe to be named later or something?
I don't know. They haven't
that.
Offered a reward on the tips outline yet.
Probably not. The problem is I think you're going to be okay once you get out of your side streets. That's going to be the biggest problem with icy conditions there. But most of the major arteries in Kansas City are pretty dry, and they should stay that way for most of the day. As far as the 8 a.m. forecast is concerned, we are looking for mostly sunny skies. Just a few slick spots near your doorstep. Wind chills will be in the single digits below zero. The temperature right at 21 degrees. The winds will be northwesterly at 10 to 15 miles an hour. By noontime, lots of sunshine, but winter wear is still apropos. Chills in the single digits. The temperature right at 29 degrees by noon. Northwest winds at 10 to 20. Looking at 3 p.m., school's out, but school is in session, is it or not?
This is a holiday. So, President's Day.
So we'll see. Sunshine, as you saw on the graphic, with temperatures rising through the 30s. So we are talking about temperatures to warm up into the 30s. They should stay that way, so maybe by the late afternoon hours, by the time you head home, we'll have some wet spots on the road as opposed to ice.
But you're expecting the roads to get better as our temperatures climb?
I think so. We can handle a little water on the roads, don't you think?
I think so, but you know, driving may not be all that much fun this morning. It was somewhat slippery when we came in, and Myron Warnell involving an ATA bus, an accident there in Overland Park, injury accident 71st and Metcalf. Major freeways reported fairly clear, but residential streets are slick. And one more area you may want to watch out for in Shawnee, fire units are answering a call at 5900 Flint. So you may want to watch for some fire crews there. Coming up on the First News, we'll tell you what Walter Cronkite and Union Station have in common.
And show you what kids can do with Legos. This is the First News at 6:35.
And it is 6:35 in the morning. We'll be back after this.
Both of us, in unison.
Yes.